The implications of the COVID-19 pandemic on climate change and climate action are two-sided. In the positive sense, there's been a reduction in hydrocarbons pollution as many industrial activities are shut down and people are forced to stay home and to work from home. Also, a lot more people are conscious of the need for alternative sources of energy, especially solar energy. There's been a really low demand for oil and the prices of oil have greatly crashed. Even in agriculture, there's been a reduction in emissions of hydrocarbons as there is less mechanized farming, especially in places where these machines are controlled and owned by governments and they are being held back. So we see people gardening and tending more to soils, and this highlights the importance of agroecological farming. On the other hand, however, climate action may be stalled as people are not able to move from place to place, and there can't be large gatherings, which affects even the annual Conference of Parties of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Attention is given to the pandemic, and so it's expected that the efforts at climate change mitigation may be overtaken. However, conversations and campaigns on climate change mitigation must continue virtually. Climate change is still an emergency, and so global climate leaders must keep up with efforts to cut hydrocarbons emission. We hope that this experience at fighting this great challenge will build confidence towards a collective response to climate change and also encourage personal responsibility.